Listen, friends.
The adventure begins.
A long time ago, on the island of Sodor, there was a little railway known as the Northwestern. The smallest engine working on the main line was Edward. He helped with shunting cars and coaches in the yard for the larger engines. The biggest engine on the railway was Gordon. He loved pulling the express, but he didn't much care for some of his other jobs.
A goods train.
A goods train.
The shame of it. Oh, the shame of it.
Oh, Gordon.
It can't be that bad.
Yes, Edward, it is. I am a very important engine, but thankfully I won't have to pull goods trains for long. Not after the new engine gets here.
New engine? What new engine?
Haven't you heard? Sir Topham Hatt is getting another engine. That last one he got, with the wooden brake blocks, was much too small to be really useful.
But I'm not small!
James.
I might not be as big as you, Gordon, but I'm bigger than Edward.
And there's nothing wrong with wooden brake blocks either.
Unless they catch fire, of course. Can you move on now, please, James? You're blocking my way.
My brakes don't catch fire. They're just as good as yours.
Pulling heavy goods trains. But he especially didn't like pulling them up that big hill on the main line.
I give up.
What's he up to now? Even trying.
I can't do it. Those noisy cars hold an engine back. If they were coaches, now that would be different.
Hello? Hello?
The man in charge of the little railway was Sir Topham Hatt.
I see.
It was his job to make sure all the trains ran on time.
Oh, dear. Okay. Goodbye.
Hello, Edward. I'm afraid Gordon needs your help.
My help, sir? Are you sure?
Yes. He can't get up the hill with his goods cars, apparently.
Okay, sir. I'm on my way. Hello, Gordon. I've come to push.
No use at all. A small engine like you.
Oh, please, Gordon, try.
All right, all right. I can't do it.
I will do it.
I can't do it.
I will do it.
I can't do it.
I will do it.
Later, Edward was back in the yard.
when he heard a voice he'd never heard before.
Excuse me, can you tell me where Knapford is?
But this is Knapford. Where are you from?
Oh, right, on the mainland.
Sir Topham Hatt's new engine.
Edward couldn't believe his eyes.
The new engine had 6 small wheels, a short stumpy boiler, a short stumpy dome, and a short stumpy funnel.
All wanted to come here.
Hello? What's the matter? Do I have soot on my face?
No, it's just, well, you're not a big engine.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Well, I was big enough to do my work on the mainland.
Wait, wait! All I meant was, you're not as big as I am.
I may not be as big as you, but I'm very hardworking.
And who are you?
I'm Thomas.
The new engine.
Oh, dear. Sir Topham Hatt must have made a terrible mistake. I think he was expecting someone really useful.
I am really useful.
For fetching coaches, perhaps. Oh well, if you stick around long enough, you might be lucky enough to see me pulling the express. That will be a fine sight for you.
Sorry about Gordon, Thomas. I'm afraid he's often like that. I'm Edward, by the way.
And I'm James.
Hello.
And here comes the boss.
Sir Topham Hatt.
Oh, you must be Thomas, my new tank engine. Welcome to Sodor. I am Sir Topham Hatt.
Pleased to meet you.
Sir, you're supposed to call him sir.
Oh, I'm pleased to meet you, sir.
I'm very pleased to meet you, too. Now, as you can see, I'm a very busy man, and this is a very busy railway. So, I expect you to make yourself really useful right away. Edward will show you what to do. Yes. Really useful. Yes. Right. Carry on. This way, lads.
He's a really useful engine, you know. All the other engines, they'll tell you so. He huffs and puffs and whistles, rushing to and fro. He's the really useful engine we adore.
Oops, sorry.
He's the one.
Oh.
He's
the
really useful engine we all know. He's the one.
That's very useful, isn't it? Having another small engine to get in the way.
He's still learning, Gordon. I'm just showing him what to do.
Thomas!
Oh, oh.
He's a really useful engine, you know. Maybe a little. Just you watch him go. He's the really useful engine we adore.
He's the one.
What's this?
Thomas was the smallest engine at Tidmouth's yacht. But at least his new friend Edward was there too.
I like being on Sodor, Edward. I just can't wait until I get to pull trains.
You better learn how to shunt cars and coaches first, Thomas.
Oh, I'll soon get the hang of shunting, Edward. But I want to see the world.
A very kind engine, but he's a bit of a worrier. And he doesn't like rain. An engine attached to a train was afraid of a few drops of rain.
He rushed into a tunnel and squeaked through his funnel and never came out again.
His driver and fireman argued with him, but he wouldn't budge. The rain will spoil my lovely green paint and red stripes, he said.
The passengers got off and argued with him too. But he wouldn't move, even after the rain had stopped. So, Sir Topham Hatt told the guard to get a rope and...
1, 2, 3, pull!
Everyone pulled.
Come on, pull harder. Come on, everyone, stop moving.
Except Sir Topham Hatt.
My doctor has forbidden me to pull.
When that didn't work... They tried pushing from the other end.
1, 2, 3, push! Everybody push! Harder! Come on! Put your backs into it! My doctor has also forbidden me to push.
They tried pushing with an engine, too. Nothing worked. In the end, they took up the old rails, built a wall in front of him, and left him there. Oh, Sir Topham Hatt let him out eventually, after Gordon burst his safety valve and couldn't pull
it. All right, story time is over. Some of us have to get some sleep.
Oh.
Sir Topham Hatt sent Thomas to the steamworks to be repainted in the colors he liked to see on the Northwestern Railway.
Thank you.
I'm the best?
The last number one was a coffee pot.
Coffee pot?
Coffee pot is just a nickname for an engine with a boiler that points up in the air. Like those things people make coffee in. The coffee pot engines used to look after one of the branch lines, but they don't work there now. Although, I think the last one might still be on a siding.
Stop chatting and bring me my coaches!
Oh, you better do it, Thomas. I have a train to pull today.
But I thought we were going to be working together.
We are, just not all the time.
My coaches!
I say, where are you taking us?
To Gordon. It's time for the express.
But we're not the express coaches. I'm Eddie, and she is Claribel.
And the express coaches are on the other sidings.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, your ladyships. You see, I'm new around here. I'm Thomas.
What a sweet little engine.
Indeed, Annie. Delightful.
We'll go far, Claribel.
Just you wait and see.
Thomas wasn't used to working in the yard on his own. It was very busy all day long.
Something smoky, James? Like a burning smell?
No, not really. Nothing out of the ordinary.
Hello, Thomas.
Hello, Henry.
Henry, can I ask you something? Did you really hide in a tunnel because of some rain?
Yes, Thomas, I did.
But, well, rain is just water. The same as you put in your boiler. So, how could you be afraid of it?
I don't know, Thomas. I can't explain it. I just am. And I don't like being teased about it.
But I'm not teasing, Henry. I was just asking. I mean, you can't stop the rain, and you don't want to go around worrying all the time.
Oh, I don't worry all the time, Thomas. I hardly worry at all when it's sunny.
Huh?
The next morning, Thomas found it hard to wake up. His fire went out, and there wasn't enough steam.
You need to wake up, Thomas. It's nearly time for the express. Gordon will be waiting for his coaches.
At last, Thomas started.
Oh dear, oh dear. Must get going, must get going.
Hurry up, you!
Hurry up yourself.
Yes, I will.
Gordon hadn't forgiven Thomas for waking him up from his nap. He started up so quickly.
Oh, gosh.
But there was no time to uncouple Thomas.
Hold on!
To go on.
Edward! Thomas!
Express coming through!
The train now approaching platform 1 is the 817 Express to Vickerstown.
Oh, yes.
Well, little Thomas, now you know what hard work is like, don't you?
Poor Thomas tucks slowly away to rest. And had a long, long sleep. Next day, he was back in the yard again.
It's not fair. All the engines pull trains except for me. I never go anywhere. I wonder where those cars are meant to be going.
Accident.
Is an engine off the rails?
Or is it a breakdown?
A fire?
A bridge out?
No. I just wondered where you were going, that's all.
Thomas? Over here?
Sorry to disturb you.
Disturb us?
Oh, an
emergencies never disturb us, do they, Jerome?
Honey, you don't want to go wasting time.
Just in case we're needed. You mustn't touch those cars.
That's the breakdown train.
But why are they in the yard if they're not meant to be shunted? Don't they ever go anywhere?
Only in emergencies.
Like when a poor, helpless coach needs lifting back onto the rails.
Okay, I won't bother them again. Oh, ta-da!
You can take my cars away now, Thomas. I'm ready for my coaches.
You're such a show-off, James.
Maybe I am. But you just wait and see if Sir Topham Hatt doesn't give me my own branch line soon.
There's that burning smell again.
One morning, Henry wasn't feeling well.
He wouldn't come out of the shed.
Is it because you think it might rain today, Henry?
No, Thomas. I think there's something wrong with my boiler. I might not be able to pull my coaches today.
Maybe your firebox needs warming up. I'll go and fetch your coaches.
What are you so happy about today, Thomas?
If Henry doesn't come, I might get to pull his train.
It's not as easy as you think, Thomas. Pulling trains is hard work.
Thomas waited and waited. But still, Henry didn't come.
Oh. You'll have to find another engine.
There's only Thomas, sir.
You'll have to do it then, Thomas. Be quick now.
Yes, sir.
Thomas raced around to the front of the coaches and backed up to them with a bump.
Oh, don't be impatient now, Thomas. Wait until everything is ready.
But Thomas was far too excited and not really listening. Whistle, so he took off before his coaches could be coupled up.
Thomas, stop! Come back!
I'm doing it! I'm pulling a train!
Thomas? Where are you going? I thought you were working in the yard.
Can't you see I'm pulling coaches, James? Dad says it's hard to pull trains. But I think it's easy.
Right. Yeah.
See me pulling a train before. Ah, it's nice of them to wave. Oh, bother. That red signal means danger. I have to stop. What a nuisance signals are.
Hello, Thomas. What are you doing here?
I'm pulling my very first passenger train. Can't you see?
Really? Then where are your coaches?
Oh, no!
Back at the station, passengers were all talking at once,
telling Sir Topham Hatt what a bad railway it was.
Please, everybody, please calm down. We will find another engine as soon as we...
Sorry, sir. I really am.
I did say to wait until everything was ready, Thomas.
This time, Thomas waited to be coupled up and for the passengers to climb on board.
Ready?
Yes, Thomas. Now we're ready.
The other engines thought it was very funny when they heard the story of Thomas's train.
I'm glad you came to work on our railway, Thomas. You always give us something funny to laugh about.
Sir Topham Hatt will never let me pull trains again. But I want to go places and do things. I want to
see the world.
Don't be sad, Thomas. If you really want to go out, why don't you take my goods train tomorrow? I can take over in the yard if you like.
Really? Would you do that, Edward, for me?
Yes, Thomas, I would. Now let's get some sleep, okay?
Oh, Edward, I wish it was morning.
The next morning, Thomas could hardly contain his excitement.
Is it these ones? Is it those? Which cars are they, Edward?
Those cars, Thomas, but wait, I need to tell you something.
I know. I have to be coupled up before I go. You don't have to tell me. I've learned my lesson.
Troublesome trucks can play tricks on you, Thomas. It's not the same as in the yard. They'll push you off the rails if you're not careful.
Don't be silly. You worry too much, Edward. Like Henry.
The engines always think they are so clever. And so they like to bump the trucks around. They bump them in the sidings. They bump them in the yard.
Thomas, be